right, so when you're making a moving boat ADCP measurement, one of the things you really need to consider is whether or not you have a moving bed present. So what's a moving bed? It's when sediment is moving down the bottom of the stream. So it's actually moving along the bottom, and we're relying on our acoustic beams to track where we are, how fast we're moving in the direction. And if there's something saltating and moving along the bottom of the stream, that's going to impact our bottom track measurement. So if you're only relying on bottom track, it's really, really critical to know if you have a moving bed or not, because you'll need to overcome that. When the sediment is migrating downstream along the bottom, it's actually going to place your bottom track as if it's migrating upstream, and that will ultimately lower your discharge, and that's not good. So there are ways to overcome this. The first is the loop test, and then the other way is the stationary moving bed analysis. These are two very different tests. They're both developed by the USGS, and we've taken their code and their rules and just implemented that directly into both of our moving boat software programs, River Surveyor Live for the M9 and RSQ for the RS5. So you can run the loop test and the SMBA test directly in those software programs. The loop test has several criteria. The first is that you have to have a well-calibrated compass. The second is that you must have valid bottom track data all the way across. And then the third is that you need to have a sufficient mean velocity, and that is 0.24 meters per second. And then the fourth criteria is that you must start and stop at the exact same position. And so the loop means you're driving in a loop. So you're gonna start at your start edge, you're gonna loop around and back, and you must start and end at that exact same position. So if you can check off all four of those criteria, then a loop test might be a great way for you to test for a moving bed. It does require a really good boat operator. So if you're a little nervous about that, maybe you switch to an SMBA. The SMBA is a lot easier to collect. You're going to push your boat out to the swiftest, fastest, deepest section, and then you're going to collect 300 seconds of data, and you're basically looking to see if the position of the ADCP is migrating upstream. That would indicate that you have a moving bed, and that would bias your discharge low. So when that happens, it will recommend that you collect two more SMBA tests. So that means another 5-minute sampling session on one side of that center point and another 5-minute sampling session on the other. So right there, that's 15 minutes. That's a lot of time before you're actually out collecting your discharge measurement. So a loop test is gonna get you on the water faster. It's gonna give you a little bit of recon of what your site looks like, because you're gonna go out and back, and it'll give you some idea of what you're gonna encounter as you make your discharge measurement. Both of those tests, as I said, are available in the software. You'll get the results directly on the screen, and you'll know whether or not you need to apply one of those.
Before we start our actual discharge measurement, we need to check if there's a moving bed condition at this site. And one of the ways you can do that is to do a loop method, or a loop test. So I've clicked on the add loop, and now I've filled out the smart page, and now I'm gonna say start sampling. So a critical piece here is that Brittany, who's operating the boat, starts and ends at the exact same location. It doesn't matter too much what the boat path between the start and end, but crosswise on the cross section and up and down the river, the boat needs to start and stop in the same spot. So Brittany has marked our bank operated cableway line on the top and the bottom. So once those line up, she'll be back at this spot. So she's gonna go out to the far bank, almost to the far bank, and then back after I start the sampling. So I'm going to click start sampling, and the computer is going to talk to the instrument, and then we are now in the preview mode, and I'm going to say start loop. And okay, Brittany, start. A critical piece here is that the loop method can be used to correct a bottom track referenced measurement with moving bed, and you don't always need to calibrate the compass for a bottom track measurement, but you do for a loop. So, and you should always have some kind of moving bed test to make sure you don't have a moving bed present. So in a sense, you should always calibrate the compass at each site you go to, even if you're going to be referencing bottom track. Okay, now, so Brittany is approaching the location where she stopped. She's gonna line up her marks. Okay, she's told me she's in exactly the same location where she stopped, so I'll click F5 or finish, click the finish icon. And so moving bed velocity is below the minimum moving bed criteria, so no correction is recommended, but the difference in flow direction between out and back is 1.4 degrees. So we don't have a moving bed, so we could click continue to start edge here. So before we start our measurement, we talked about we need to assess whether there is a moving bed condition at a site. We showed the loop method, and if it's not possible to do a loop method to test for a moving bed, or your loop is failing for whatever reason, then that you have another option to test for a moving bed, which is called stationary moving bed analysis, or SMBA for short. To add an SMBA test for a moving bed, we click the add SMBA button here at the top, and then it's going to default to one measurement, 300 samples per measurement, which is what is recommended by many agencies. So I'm going to click OK, and basically what we need to do is keep the boat in more or less a stationary position in the middle of the channel. So I'm going to click start sampling. And then now we're in preview mode, and then I'm going to say I can click F5 or start SMBA. So now the stationary moving bed analysis has started. So basically what the system is doing is just measuring the velocity and the boat location using the acoustics for 300 seconds or 5 minutes. So if you can see here in the center plot, the boat location is indicated by the bullseye, and then the straight lines, or it's not moving around a whole lot, but then you have velocity vectors going downstream behind it. Basically, the system is testing to see if there is a moving bed, it will register that it's moving upstream instead of stationary, but we've told it we're doing a stationary moving bed analysis and that the boat should be stationary. So from that, the software can compute if there is a stationary, or if there is a moving bed, and how fast it is moving. So this is gonna collect and average the position and the velocities for 300 seconds. Okay, so we've hit 300 seconds, and the results are shown here, and no correction is recommended. So basically, the results of the stationary moving bed analysis is that we do not have a moving bed at this site. If we had discovered we do have a moving bed at this site, the best practices recommend that you then do an SMBA test at two other locations along your transect to correctly account for a moving bed. So with that, we're ready to move into the transect and make a measurement.